Hey, what's up guys? Back with another video. This time I'm showing how to cast and paint a Star Wars clone trooper helmet. This one being from episode 3. Same as everything else I cast, I use smooth on 320. And no, I have no clue why that part A in the yellow container there is sparkling. It's just the way the video turned out. But anyways, same as everything else, it's 50-50. Or a 1-to-1 ratio. And this stuff is good because when you're doing stormtrooper helmets, it casts as a white, and instead of like a black or a gray like every other resins, which is really good because then you don't have to paint the whole helmet. You just paint whatever needs to be painted. This stuff cures pretty quick. Want to do really fast, thin layers for the first two or three swishes around inside the helmet, and then after that you want to let it sit for a few seconds and cure up. It'll get real slushy. Just go real slow over every corner and make sure no air pockets fill in there. And as you can see, it's starting to cure up, so it's starting to thicken a little bit. This is good for when you put your last few thick coats on. Usually about 10 or 15 coats of this works pretty decent. Usually cures about 4 minutes, depending how long you let sit there. And I, as you can see, I probably have about 3 or 4 coats here. It really doesn't take that much resin to make these. Now, pretty much after that step is done, I'll just let it sit for 30 minutes just in case anything needs to dry or one of the in-between coats isn't cured all the way. And then I want to go ahead and demold it, and pretty much you got a fresh casting right there, ready to go. Now for this one, I'm going to go for the blue 501st version seen in episode 3, which is one of my favorite versions of the Star Wars helmet. And like I said on all my other videos, I use the cheapest stuff that anyone could find around there, wherever they're from. Walmart, Ace Hardware is usually I get my stuff at. And I've got latex I've already splattered on the helmet that will, after the paint dries, you can peel it off and you can have blast mark effects. It's a real neat trick to put scrapes across whatever it is you're painting. I like using the nozzle, the red nozzle that fans out the paint. It makes it stick a lot better and it just coats it so much more evenly. Paint's pretty good. It usually dries in about 15 minutes in the sun. I wouldn't try it anything under 60 degrees, then it might stick. It might not even stick to the whatever it is you're painting. But after this, I've got about 4 solid coats on this. Let it sit for about 30 minutes. And then you can go ahead and start peeling off all the little latex. And it just leaves perfect little abrasions. Now when I did this one, I made it look as close as possible as the famous close-up scene right after they attacked the Jedi Temple. Yeah, that latex comes off real easy. And if you get spider marks like that that went under the tape, since it's white, you can go ahead and scuff it up with like a 400 grit sandpaper or 300 and it'll take it off. Now, more and more, the most time consuming part of painting these helmets is the taping. Taping off all these little sections just for a few seconds of paint, but it's, you gotta do what you gotta do. I'm just putting down the gray. Everything that's gray goes on this time. And then after I hit it with the gray, I'll use some of my acrylic clear coat in a can. And that'll just seal it in, especially when I do a wash or I gotta tape off some more. I just use watered down acrylic paint. I mean, you can use spray paint or the automotive paint that you can get if you're doing like a high quality version. But once you put the wash on and you get a good clear coat over it, you're not going to tell the difference. And once the black is clean there, you can just peel it off. Maybe give it a scuff with a scuff pad. Got latex on here too. It's a lot easier than actually taking a knife or something to scrape it off. It just looks a lot better and so much easier to do. Just taping, painting the trim, Rust-Oleum, black, satin black is what I use for just about everything. It sticks really well, never chips off. Then after I paint that, I'll just give it a slight clear coat so it doesn't rub off at all. Let that sit in the sun. 15 minutes, let it dry. If it's colder out, 50s, 60s, I'd let it sit for about an hour. Alright, my favorite part, everything I do, I wash it with dirt, or dirty water, like a brown, black, mixed really watered down. This is where you're going to get your character from. I don't like any of my helmets clean, I like them dirty. No shinies when I'm working. Now with the green one, the Commander Gree, I'll just give it a wash and I won't even wipe it off. I'll just let it sit there. Because, you know, they're fighting in the swamps of Kashyyyk, so they're going to be really muddy and grungy and dirty anyway. So I don't even wipe it off. I just let it settle. It turns out pretty good. I mean, you can let it dry completely and then wipe it off, or you can just wipe it down when it's wet and it'll give it like a streaky look. When you wipe it down, you want to use like a microfiber cloth, especially if it's on a smooth surface like this. As you can see, that rag's not really doing very good, so you'll switch out to a microfiber and clean it off. I don't even try to get the corners. I just leave as much on there as possible. As much as if it looked like it was actually out in the field or in a war battle zone, wherever it's doing. Not too bad. I cleaned it up. I didn't want it to be completely dirty. But for blast marks, like my Terminators, I'll just burn or singe it, because then it gives it like the orange burn that you see in the movies. It's really hard to duplicate that with paint, because it'll just rub off, but the burn mark will actually stay into the plastic. And the heat off that really gives a really good burn mark too. Or blast mark, or whatever you want to call it. Alright, now pretty much since that's all done, I'm going to put the lenses in, and that's going to be pretty much it. All the lenses are that I use is a 16th of an inch plexiglass. I got these from Hobby Lobby, I think. Hobby Lobby or Michaels usually has this. And then I go ahead and I just use window tint, which you can get anywhere, like at AutoZone or even Walmart, I think, has it. But don't get the cheap kind, get like the $10, $15 kind. Tint it. You guys know how to tint, it's not too hard, you just water it down, use a credit card, you know, make sure it's adhered, use a dryer, dry it so that it sticks, and that's pretty much it. I just hot glue the lenses in. I'll tape them down first and go ahead and hot glue them in, and they usually work pretty good. So there it is, there's the final version right there. Star Wars Episode 3 Clonetrooper Helmet. I hope you all learned something and enjoyed watching this video. I'll have more videos up soon, but until then, thanks for watching, and always, don't forget to subscribe.